out of nothing, 13.8 billion years ago, billions of planets, stars, and galaxies were birthed. And today, we've made one of these galaxies our home. But there's a high chance that there's not one of you, but billions of copies. And the James Webb Space Telescope just confirmed it. In 2018, 3 years before the most powerful telescope ever made was launched into space, Professor Hawking, alongside Thomas Hertog, published the Multiverse Theory, one of the craziest theories about our universe. He and his partner proposed that billions of universes were born along with our Milky Way during the Big Bang. Not only that, Hawking said that for every human on Earth, there were infinite copies of such existing in other universes. Stephen Hawking was a strong believer in the Big Bang theory, and most of the theories agreed with it. He made it clear he didn't go with the idea of a creator, but his theories were even more mind-boggling. One such was his prophecies about the future of humanity, in which he claims that the God particle would cause a vacuum bubble to form, engulfing the whole universe and opening it up to hostile extraterrestrial invasions and artificial intelligence takeovers. There have always been speculations that there are other beings in our universe, like aliens, and the possibilities become even more glaring. But there has never been solid proof to support the idea that there are multiples of universes with humans that look, walk, and talk like us, until the James Webb Telescope began sending in photos from space. Are we truly alone in this world? Watch this. Stephen Hawking's theory of multiverse and black holes is one that has instigated a bunch of arguments among scientists and science lovers. It has also inspired a lot of movies, with DC and Marvel holding the helm. The idea of a multiverse sounds like something from a cartoon, but the James Webb Space Telescope is getting the first chance to assess the viability of Stephen Hawking's most controversial theories. Astronomers are quite confident that the James Webb Telescope holds the key to proving Stephen Hawking's theory, because so far, the James Webb Telescope has offered so much insight into theories that we never allowed ourselves to believe to be true or possible. The telescope has a primary mirror that is 6.5 meters in diameter, which is much larger than the 2.4 meter mirror of the Hubble Space Telescope. The larger mirror will allow the James Webb Telescope to collect more light and thus enable it to observe fainter objects. Its ability to observe objects in redshifts helps astronomers to study distant galaxies and surrounding planets and search for signs of life within the solar system. According to Stephen Hawking's multiverse theory, there are an infinite number of universes, each with its laws of physics, and there is no way for us to know what these laws are. However, some universes may be hospitable to life, while others may not. The James Webb Telescope will allow us to peer into other universes and see if they contain the same kind of life that we have here on Earth. If other universes do exist, then it is possible that we are just one small part of a much larger multiverse. The implications of the multiverse theory are far-reaching and have implications for many areas of physics and cosmology. One implication is that the idea of a unique universe, as described by the Big Bang theory, is replaced by the idea of a vast, possibly infinite number of universes, each with its own physical properties and constants. This could help explain why our own universe appears to be fine-tuned for the existence of life. Other implications include the possibility of parallel universes and the possibility of multiple versions of ourselves. The multiverse theory also has implications for the concept of cause and effect, as events in one universe may not have a direct cause and effect relationship with events in another universe. This means that anything can happen and will eventually happen in one universe or another. So, If there's a universe out there where aliens have already discovered us, then we're probably just a curiosity to them. In another universe, we might be the ones doing the discovery. In 2016, NASA made a discovery that scientists believe supports the theory of a parallel universe following its Antarctic impulsive transient antenna, called ANITA. ANITA detected evidence of high-energy particles called neutrinos coming up from the Earth's surface. It happened a second time in 2018. There wasn't an explanation for this, so they attributed the anomaly to exotic physics. This is because exotic physics accommodates theories beyond our current understanding of physics, and the multiverse is one of them. But of course, not everyone in the scientific world supports Stephen Hawking's ideas. They dismiss the concept because it is not on the same level as established scientific theories, such as relativity and quantum mechanics. According to them, the multiverse theorists do not clearly communicate this to the public, which can negatively impact the public's perception and acceptance of science. They claim that theorists may be attempting to redefine the scientific method, prioritizing their own agendas over the connection between theory and empirical evidence, which can lead to a decline in the importance of evidence in science. Another popular theory from Stephen Hawking's is the black hole. Black holes are extremely dense regions in space where the gravitational pull is so strong that nothing, not even light, can escape. Though invisible, their presence can be detected by observing their effects on nearby matter. They can have a significant impact on their surroundings, including warping space-time and influencing the orbits of nearby planets and stars. Astronomers explained that black holes are formed only after massive stars die, then collapse under the weight of their own gravity. Making black holes requires many stars, which requires a bunch of normal matter. Now, scientists know how much normal matter is in the universe from the calculations of the early universe. But they believe that there simply isn't enough normal matter to make all the dark matter, which makes up over 80% of all the matter in the universe. In 1971, Stephen Hawking suggested that black holes formed in the chaotic environment of the earliest moments of the Big Bang. He had explained that pockets of matter could spontaneously reach the densities needed to make black holes, flooding the cosmos with them well before the first stars twinkled. He further also suggested that these primordial black holes might be responsible for dark matter. Recently, scientists began looking into the theory of primordial black holes, exploring how they might explain the dark matter and possibly resolve the other cosmological challenges. They found that primordial black holes could play a major role in the universe by seeking the first stars, the first galaxies, and the first supermassive black holes. They also said that their observations indicate that stars, galaxies, and supermassive black holes appear very quickly in cosmological history, perhaps too quickly to be accounted for by the processes of formation and growth observed in the present-day universe. While this idea is still a model, scientists believe that this could be tested relatively soon. They said that the James Webb Space Telescope is specifically designed to answer questions about the origins of stars and galaxies. It has been nearly a century since Edwin Hubble discovered that the universe is expanding. This discovery led to the development of the Big Bang Theory, which posits that our universe began as a singularity that exploded into existence. While the Big Bang Theory is widely accepted, there are still some open questions about what came before the Big Bang and what happened during and after the initial explosion. One of the leading theories to explain these open questions is the multiverse theory. The James Webb Telescope will be a powerful tool in testing the multiverse theory. The telescope's ability to see deep into space will allow astronomers to study objects that formed shortly after the Big Bang. By studying these early objects, astronomers will be able to test whether or not our universe is part of a larger multiverse. Additionally, the next generation of gravitational wave detectors, especially the laser interferometer space antenna, is poised to reveal much more about black holes, including primordial ones, if they exist. Astronomers say that the two observatories should give them enough information to put together the story of the first stars and potentially the origins of dark matter. Ultimately, the consequences of the multiverse theory are both fascinating and troubling. On one hand, it suggests that anything is possible. On the other hand, it makes our universe seem rather insignificant in comparison to all the others that are out there. Priyamvada Natarajan, an astrophysicist at Yale, said, "What I find personally super exciting about this idea is how it elegantly unifies the two really challenging problems that I work on, that of probing the nature of dark matter and the formation and growth of black holes, and resolves them in one fell swoop." Whether you are like Priyamvada, who is optimistic about the discoveries, or like the other scientists that think the multiverse theory doesn't hold water, none changes the fact that our universe is still too complex for our comprehension.